Okay, let's look at another type of mixture problem. I made up this problem, guys, so I don't know if you can really find this thing in the store. Okay, this really makes sense. But just to give you a sense of how mixture problems work, let's read this. This problem number 17 is about a chocolate lover mixes three types of chocolate chips to make 10 pounds of trail mix that is 40% sugar and 40% fat. You know what a trail mix is, right? Usually it's made up of what?
Nuts, raisins, M&M's,
chocolate. But this guy likes chocolates only, so his trail mix is
chocolate.
Made of the chocolate. Okay, all right. Type A is 30% sugar and 60% fat. So these are the types of the chocolate chips, okay? Type B is 50% sugar and 40% fat. And type C is 40% sugar and 30% fat. Again, there's no such thing, okay? This is make-believe. How many pounds of each should be mixed? Question mark. Okay, so we saw nickels, dimes, and quarters problem. So again, maybe you will say, well, this is a mixture problem. Recommendation is to try to organize your thoughts by drawing a chart, right? And again, I said in Math 125, usually we ask you to mix not just two things, but three things. What are the three things we are mixing?
A, B, C,
right? So we have A, B, C, we're mixing those, all right? We want to know how many pounds of each, right? We need, so again, the first row in the representation, we'll talk of what? Number of pounds, right? Okay, number of pounds, LBS, okay, right? Number of pounds, do we know?
Yeah.
We don't, right? So therefore, we call them what?
X, Y, Z.
X, Y, Z, okay? Again, because we have three variables, X, Y, Z, how many equations are we hoping to produce here at the bottom here?
Three.
1, 2, 3. Okay? Okay, breathe. Do we have one right away without finishing the R part?
Yes.
X, Y,
Y plus Z equals 10 pounds.
Very good. Okay, we already know that when we mix X plus Y plus Z, we want to get 10 pounds. Okay? We need to look for two more equations, right? Okay? Where do you think that will come from? This is slightly worded differently, okay? So, over there when we were doing the nickels, dimes, and quarters problem, we were looking at the value of the coins, right? Now, let's pause and think of this problem. We have chocolate chips that have what? What two things does the chocolate lover want about the chocolate chips?
Sugar
and the fat, right? The chocolate lover loves sugar and fat, right? So probably you're thinking, oh, maybe the next two sentences will come from what? The sugar and the fat. So maybe we should represent those first, okay? Namely, you can call this row the sugar content, how much sugar, right? Okay? And this third row as the fat content of the mix, all right? Okay, do we know anything about the sugar content of type A chocolate?
Yes, it's 30%.
It's 30% sugar. If it's 30% sugar and you have X pounds of it, how much sugar do you have? It's 30%, so 0.30 times X. Okay, do you want to keep the decimal point or drop it?
Drop.
You sure?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Okay.
So 30X, right? Everybody clear where the 30 came from? Okay, just make sure you know that's percent, right? 30% times X. Now, what about sugar? Chocolate B, do we know how much sugar it has? 50%, right? So therefore, this will be what?
51.
And how much for C?
40,
right? Okay,
40
Z. Clear?
Yes.
Okay, so then you can help me with the fat content. What should go 60X. Here?
60X.
Fat is 60X, right?
40Y.
Which one?
40Y.
40Y, right?
And 10Z.
30Z. Very good. Okay? How are we going to use these two rows in the representation to produce the two equations?
30X plus 51.
Okay.
Plus 40Z.
Okay, wait, so Svetlana, slow down. These are all sugar, right?
Yeah.
He wants to mix, so he wants to have 30X add, right? Very good. Okay. 50Y plus 40Z. That's going to be here, right? And if you add up all the sugar content, you want it to be what?
40%.
You want it to be 40% of the total, right? Understand? Okay, so how will I write that? We drop the decimal point, so it will be 40 times 10. Is that clear why it's 40 times 10? The same way we multiply each one by this, right? So total is 10, correct? Okay? So therefore, if you want the total sugar to be 40%, so it's 40 times 10. That's your right. Okay? So who wants to try the next one? So for fat, all you do is what? Add them up, right? 60X plus 40Y plus 30Z, right? How much fat do we want for the
40%?
Also, so 40 times 10. I don't know what the rest of the mix would be consisting of. Okay, maybe some salt. All right, so we didn't think of that. So did you guys understand how to do this? Okay, and again, I want you to stop there, and I don't know if the problem makes sense, but the exercise is just mainly knowing how to read and translate, okay? Okay, again, I think there's some confusion about the numbers 30, 50, 40. Remember, these guys are what?
Percent.
These are percents, right? So actually, for numbers, we really need to see what?
Decimal point,
right? Okay? You cannot, so you want to get the entire sugar content for the 10 pounds, so it's 40% of the 10, okay? So we have 0.40 times 10. But because everybody has decimal points, what do?
Multiply all
of
them.
We can actually just multiply everybody by 100 and forget that. It's the same idea here. This thing is the sugar content. You have 10 pounds of the chocolate chips, right? To get the sugar content of that, you know it's 40% sugar, right? So therefore you get 40% of the 10 pounds, which is what? What's 40% of 10? 4 pounds of sugar. Can you imagine eating 4 pounds of sugar, right? Okay. This is a crazy mix. Okay.